Yeah, like you're about to fucking hit me. Thank you. I just got on camera.
Good. Goodbye. Goodbye. Yeah.
My mom stabbed me, please help.
Hey, my name's Kat, and I really need some help. I'm trying to move out of my parents' abusive household, and they made me so financially dependent on them that I have nothing without them. So I'm trying to get a car, and they've never let me buy a car before. So, I made a GoFundMe so that hopefully I can raise enough money to get a car so that I can get a, keep going to my job so that I can, you know, get money to hopefully support myself on my own. I have a place to stay for now. I just have no way of getting to work. So if you guys could share this video around or check out the GoFundMe link, it's in my bio, I would really appreciate it. Because I can't go back there again.
When I was in the fifth grade, I wrote my first suicide note. I left it in my desk and my teacher found it. And my principal came to the room, took me out of the room and addressed it with me and told me I had to show my parents. Well, he did. He showed my parents and I was punished. I was punished for it because it made them look bad and they were going through a custody battle with my mom. So they took everything out of my room. They spanked me for it. They wouldn't allow me to have more than one meal a day. And they were telling my brothers that I didn't love them anymore and that I wasn't a part of the family. And they sat me down in the bathroom and made me remove myself from all of our family photos. That's what they did when they found out their little girl was suicidal. And then they wonder why, as a 25-year-old woman, I struggle to have anything to do with them. And I don't want them in my life.
You trying to make it seem like don't nobody want me? Because I promise you there's somebody that does want me.
Who?
Really, who?
Yeah, who?
Somebody.
You can't name somebody? So why you just don't go live with them?
No, I do not talk to my parents. I do forgive them. I just do not agree with what they are doing. And that is why I'm speaking out, because it still continues to this day.
Never invalidate the feelings of people who hate their parents and their family members. Our experiences are unique and you don't know their stories. You don't know their struggles and their traumas. So if you've never been disowned, abandoned, hurt, or abused, you don't know their pain. You were so lucky. You have no idea about the things that they've been through. So check your privilege. Your idea about being a grateful kid is not one size fits all.
Pokemon! Hey.
It's Pikachu!
It's the fairy!
Fuck!
Running away from our abusive home. Left out at night, scared. Never felt so free in my life. We can finally live harm-free. No one can touch us now. We are away from that.
Hi everyone. Hi to like 500,000 people that have liked the video and like a million people that have seen it. Hi. My mind is spinning. Forgive me if I can't fit everything in this video or if I sound scattered. I'm just completely overwhelmed and in like shock. Thank you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. You guys have donated $14,000 in like a day. And that means I can get a car. So like I'm not possibly gonna live on the streets and like die. I'm so beyond grateful, but it's not coming out right, but like thank you. Every single one of you has helped save my life. Hi everybody, I'm trying to fit everything in this part too. Just bear with me. I was not kidding when I said that every single one of you have saved my life. Everybody who liked the video, who shared it, who commented, who reached out to me on Instagram or left a sweet message when they donated, everyone has... I've never felt such a sense of like community before and felt so supportive and loved and cared about. Truly proving why there is still faith in humanity and the LGBT community is amazing. There's no debate. I'm sorry. There's not. I don't even know. I'm definitely going to keep you all updated on my journey. I'm just going to keep posting videos on here, I guess, and like update you guys and let you know like if I'm safe and everything. I'm looking at cars today. I'm really excited. But I'll keep going, but okay, last part, so I'm done talking. Like I said, I'm gonna keep posting, I'm gonna keep you guys updated on everything that's going on. I'm obviously still stressed, even though you guys have taken a huge, huge weight off of me by helping me raise enough money to get a car and get insurance and gas and hopefully be able to pay for my phone bill and food and stuff while I try to figure out everything. My college kicks us all out like May 17th, but so I have a little time to like create a plan. I have a few options where to stay. I've reached out to my college and they're getting back to me on whether or not they have like emergency housing for the summer. I do have a few people who have reached out that are like friends and that have offered to help me and let me stay at their house for a little while. So, if anything, I'll just be couch surfing for a while, but I will keep y'all updated. I love you. As if my life couldn't get any fucking worse. Well, guess what? It's my life! So, of course it fucking did. So, a parent of a friend of mine decided that it was her responsibility and duty to send the GoFundMe to my parents. To call my parents and tell them not only that I'm gay, but I started a GoFundMe to escape their household and get a car. So. Every time I'm so done. I'm gonna end it all. Every fucking time that it gets better, it just gets fucking worse. I hate people. Hello, kings, queens, and royal envies. I have an update. I'm sorry for worrying so many of you in the last video. I was just extremely, extremely angry and upset and just so frustrated. I have good news. A friend of mine reached out, and her mom, they have an extra bedroom in their house, and they are offering to let me stay there for as long as I need until I can get on my feet and get my own apartment. So I really am happy. I know it doesn't seem like it, but I'm just so, it's been a roller coaster of emotions in the past like 2 hours, and I'm just so drained. But a huge weight has been lifted off of my chest, so that is very good. My family is being horrible, and my brother has even texted me telling me that I robbed people of money and that I'm a horrible person. But hey, everybody, I just wanted to come on here and give you guys like a quick update. I have really good news. I found a car. Really fast, actually, like very surprisingly. It's a 2006 Mercury Mariner. It has 122,000 miles on it. It's amazing. It's a V6. It's really spacious. It's in amazing condition. I guess the guy like completely helped to redo the car. So, and there after fees and registration, he printed off the total for me. It was like $6,748, and that's with like registration, title, license plate tag, everything. I don't have car insurance yet, so I have to like figure that out. I don't really know what to do. But oh my god, just thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you from the bottom of my heart, because this would not be possible without each and every single one of you that helped me. Like no amount of words can express how grateful. God, it is so hard to fit everything I want to talk about in one like short little minute videos, but I do want to clarify, I do have a job. I work at Publix. I don't know if any of you are from Florida or from the southern states, but I do work at Publix. It's like a grocery store, but the problem is I only work one day a week right now, and the past few weeks I haven't been able to work at all because of all the shit that's been going down with my family, and my parents were my ride every week, so I just don't, I haven't been able to really work. But I do plan, once the semester ends, I can go back to working like with an open schedule, so I can work 30, 35 hours a week. I also want to start working for Instacart because that's a way more flexible schedule and you can make a lot more money on it. But, I do want to say that I have tried to buy a car for my parents before with my money that I earned from my job, and my parents always said no. They wouldn't let me get like a used car. They always would say like, oh, we don't have enough room in the driveway. You don't need a car. You are too young for a car. You don't know how much it costs. So they've just never let me pay for my health insurance, phone bills, any. Hey, so part two to what I was saying. Again, I am beyond grateful for each and every single one of you, because I would not have been able to do this if I didn't have any of you guys. I'm genuinely blown away. Over all the platforms that you could have donated on, people have raised, I believe we were at $14,500. Which is like more money than I've ever had in my bank account, and it probably like ever will for a while. But that's insane. Like I said, I have a place to stay. One of my old friends and her mother reached out to me and offered me their spare bedroom and said they would get it ready for me, give me the gate code, everything. And I can stay there as long as I need to until I can get my own apartment. So the rest of the money is going towards, hey, I just wanted to come clear some confusion on my age. I am 19. I'm not 17 or 14. I think the day 17 came from when I said May 17th is the day that we all have to move out of the college dorm, and my little sister's 14, but there's nothing I can do as of right now. I can't emancipate her. She's not old enough, and there's not enough legal evidence to get her out, and the other option is foster care, and I really don't want to put her through that. She's not a target of my parents right now, and she never really has been, so I think she'll be fine for the time being. The only reason that I can afford to go to this college is on my scholarships, my academic scholarship, and my RA advisor position, which is basically you are in charge of a group of people in a dorm and you get paid for it. So I don't have to pay for housing and board, but, what little was left over, my parents and grandparents were helping me pay. So I'm probably either going to have to take a gap year or save up money somehow this summer and try to go. But yeah, that's the update.
Many of you have been coming to my comment section talking about how my parents were terrible. Trust me, we know. I grew up in a pretty neglectful home, and we were super poor, so due to these two factors, it did become abusive at many times. When I was a kid, my dad was a truck driver, and due to him being a truck driver, he would leave us weekly alone with our mom. So my mom was basically a single mom. My mom has a form of PTSD where she zones out when she's stressed, and so this tends to happen a lot with her being a single mom. So a few years after my dad started truck driving, my dad ended up breaking his back, and that kind of led him to becoming an alcoholic. And so even when both my parents were in the house, they were still not necessarily there. So we kind of ended up like raising ourselves and raising each other as siblings. So yeah, we have many stories about this. So apparently many people are interested in hearing these crazy wild stories. So yeah, welcome to the ride and my crazy life. Hi there. I know you had terrible parents growing up, but what kind of terrible parents did you have?
When I was in the psych ward, my dad told me if he had beaten me more, I wouldn't have been in there.
Hi there. I know you had terrible parents growing up, but what kind of terrible parents did you have?
When I was in the psych ward, my dad told me if he had beaten me more, I wouldn't have been in there.